Hey, it's Dutchy, and in this video I'll answer your questions about Maschine Plus, the new standalone groove box by Native Instruments. Native Instruments sent me Maschine Plus around 1 month before the official release, and as some of you might have seen, I unboxed it, tried and tested it in two live streams. One is still available here on the channel and the other one is archived for my supporters over on Patreon. During and following these live streams, I received a ton of questions from you about Maschine Plus, and I thought it would be helpful to answer them in this video. So I reached out to Mick from Native Instruments, and he kindly took some time out of his schedule to go through all of the questions I sent him and provide me with plenty of information. I cannot answer everything you asked me in this one video, but I selected the questions that I think are the most important for many of you right now. Let's dive in. Will it support external hard drives? It does not yet, but it will. Native Instruments say they are working on that feature right now. How many instances of a certain plugin can it run? Neither Native Instruments nor I, or anyone else for that matter, can give a hard number on this because it depends on a number of variables, such as the number of notes played, the number of voices, the amount of modulation going on in the preset, the effects the preset uses, and much more. Is there a limit on the number of tracks I can use? No, there is no hard limit on the number of tracks. You can simply keep adding tracks until you either run out of RAM or reach the CPU load limit. So how many tracks you can actually add to a project depends on the type and number of instruments and effects you run. I'm working on an elaborate stress test video that I'll upload to the channel soon, so be sure to subscribe. Will there be an optional battery available? Nope, there are no plans for this. Native Instruments recommend using a DC power laptop charger. They say it would give you battery times many times greater than any built-in battery could. The most recommended option that a couple of you pointed out seems to be the OmniCharge Omni 20 Plus. I do not own this, so I cannot confirm how well it works with Maschine Plus. I reached out to OmniCharge and tried to get my hands on a test unit, but they did not respond. Is the RAM upgradable? Nope, it is not. How much RAM is actually available and how much of it is used up by the operating system? Native Instruments do not share any details on this publicly. They want users to focus on the real-life performance of the instrument rather than comparing tech specs to a computer or other groovebox. So I cannot share the exact numbers with you, but Mick from Native assured me that the operating system only takes up a small portion of the RAM. That being said, these comparisons on paper really do not make much sense, as the real-life performance of an electronic instrument depends on many more factors than just the amount of RAM or the CPU clock speed. Compared to a state-of-the-art laptop, for example, a quad-core CPU and 4 GB of RAM might seem inferior. But a computer has to run a complex operating system, dozens of background utility programs, and the software you're using. All Maschine Plus has to run is Maschine Plus. Will Maschine Plus run all contact instruments in standalone mode? No. In general, contact instruments or libraries will not be compatible by default. They have to be individually ported to Maschine Plus by Native Instruments. It is likely, although not confirmed, that they will port more of their contact instruments over time. Certain more complex contact instruments might never be able to run on Maschine Plus because they are very CPU hungry and were designed to be used on much more powerful computers instead of a standalone groovebox. Can I use my own contact instruments on Maschine Plus? Yes, you can. The feature is not officially supported yet, but there's a simple workaround that I will show you in a video tutorial on the channel soon. Can I connect a USB keyboard to type in project names? That was one of the other questions I received, and the answer is no, you cannot connect a USB keyboard, as in keyboard, to the Maschine and enter names. In standalone mode, you have to use the 4D encoder to do that. But if you connect Maschine Plus to your computer and use it in standalone mode, you can of course type in names with your computer keyboard as usual. Can I connect Maschine Jam? No, support for Jam is not planned right now. Native want to focus on products that are currently available. As you might have noticed, Jam is unfortunately off the market. Can I connect third-party USB controllers? Yes, all class-compliant MIDI keyboards will work with Maschine Plus. Can I connect an external audio interface to get more audio inputs and outputs as well as phantom power for my microphone? According to Native Instruments, their own audio interfaces Audio 1, Audio 2 and Audio 6 work with Maschine Plus. I cannot confirm this because I don't own them, but if they send one over, I'm happy to test it. They also told me that third-party audio interfaces might be supported in the future, depending on user demand and feasibility. The problem being that some audio interfaces claim to be class compliant but still have some non-standard weirdness going on, which could lead to issues with Maschine Plus. Can I use Maschine Plus in plugin mode and controller mode at the same time? No, it cannot do that, but I think it's an interesting concept. Maschine Plus could take some load off your CPU while you use it in controller mode, just like a DSP processor, like a UAD2 by Universal Audio. Will it support disc streaming? No, it's currently not supported. If you're wondering why people care about disc streaming, here's some background. If you load a sample from an external hard disk or the SD card to a pad on Maschine Plus, it is transferred from the external memory to the RAM, the onboard memory. And this makes sense because RAM can be read faster than the external memory, which gives you a snappier response with less latency when you hit the pad and play a sound. The downside is that RAM is limited to 4 GB, so there's a maximum of data or samples that a Maschine project can hold. 3 GB of RAM will give you around 3 hours of 16-bit 24 kHz stereo WAV files. That's plenty. So for most users, this will likely never be a real-life issue, as they typically use shorter samples like drum hits, one-shots or some loops. Some people, however, might have a need to load multiple very large audio files, for example, to play backing tracks during a live show, use stems, or load multiple songs instead of just samples. And also some of the more complex contact instruments can use up a lot of RAM, especially orchestral instruments for scoring. In these cases, disk streaming would allow Maschine Plus to stream larger audio files directly from the external hard drive instead of buffering them in the RAM, so it wouldn't limit the maximum file size per project anymore. In real life, most users will likely never need this feature, so unless you already know you're going to work with huge samples, I wouldn't worry about it. What is the maximum length of audio tracks? Again, there's no hard limit, it's just limited by the RAM. When I connect a complete control keyboard in standalone mode, will it have all the features it has in controller mode, like scales, chords, mixer, or preset browser? Currently, they're not supported. They only work as regular MIDI keyboards. You can play the keys, but you won't get any additional information on the screens. But they are working on adding that feature soon. Can I connect a Maschine Mark III controller to Maschine Plus and use both of them simultaneously? Nope, that's not possible, but I think it's a nice idea. Who knows? Does Maschine Plus support MIDI to external synthesizers via USB? Yes, that works. I just tested it with the Arturia Microfreak. You can connect it via USB and the MIDI works as expected. I hope this covers your most urgent questions on Maschine Plus. If you have more, feel free to leave a comment and I'll answer them if I can. As I said in the intro, all answers are based on my conversation with Mick from Native Instruments. I did my best to ensure I got all the information right. In case I didn't, I'll put a correction down in the comments. As for announcements of future features, always take those with a grain of salt. Don't base your purchase decision of any musical instrument on what it might be able to do in the future, but on what it can do right now. So if Maschine Plus lacks a certain feature that you absolutely need, let Native Instruments know about it and see if they'll add it along the road. That's all I got for today. If you enjoyed the video, hit the like button and make sure to subscribe to the channel for more videos on Maschine Plus and all kinds of music gear, reviews, tutorials, you got it. Thanks for watching, see you in the next video.